One of the first cities to issue a shelter-in-place order, Los Angeles has extended its policy until May 15th. It's been in place for 3 weeks, with widespread closures of all non-essential business already changing the face of the city. The most visible change, perhaps, its notorious traffic. The city's bumper-to-bumper rush hours are now free-flowing.
It looks like the car traffic, the passenger vehicle traffic's down maybe by a third, about 33%, and the truck traffic, the heavy-duty traffic on the roads, is down by about 20%.
A university survey for wider California has found a 60% drop in traffic volume and a roughly 50% decline in collisions. And the sudden decrease in the number of cars on LA roads appears to have a direct impact on air quality.
The tailpipes that are usually burning gasoline and diesel and emitting pollutants out of those tailpipes, they're not really on our roads very much right now. And that definitely makes the air cleaner. It's not the way that we want to make the air cleaner, but it shouldn't take a pandemic to show us that it's possible to clean up our air.
The notorious smog over the LA skyline is nowhere to be seen, as the city recorded its best air quality days in decades over the last month. In an attempt to minimize the spread of the virus, beaches were added into the list of closures, leading to noticeably cleaner beaches across the county. Park rangers have also been making sure hiking trails would remain closed off to public. The environmental improvements resulting from the large-scale slowdown of all the human activity may be the silver lining in all this, but Angelinos still find it hard to get used to the new normal and worry that a return to business as usual may be still months away. Ediz Tiyansan, CGTN, Los Angeles.